Good evening, folks. My name is Amiibo Jason, and welcome to yet another installment of the Daily Wiretap, this time for the evening of April 20th. That's right, 420, 2017. Every evening, the Daily Wiretap takes a look at the biggest news in the world of Nintendo and wraps it up in a nice, neat little package so you don't have to. Let's take a look and see what happened today, shall we? Coming up first this evening, an online guide from Nintendo offers a look at the history and characters of the Legend of Zelda franchise, including a confirmation of Ganondorf's last name. Nintendo of America's official Zelda website has a brand new section allowing you to click through an online guide and learn more about the game's common elements. The main page has a condensed rundown of the creation of Hyrule at the hands of the three goddesses and how it and the Triforce came in the care of Hylia. Link, Zelda, and Ganon all get to shine as the wielders of the sacred power as well, though it's the expanded sections that offer some very interesting little facts and nods. The biggest has to be Ganondorf's section bringing back his surname that first appeared in A Link to the Past's instruction manual, his full name being Ganondorf Dragmire. Sounds kind of spooky. Regardless if you think you already know everything there is to know about The Legend of Zelda, this guide is still a pretty cool thing to look at. We highly recommend you take a look. We'll have a link in the description below if you want to give it a look yourself. Coming up next tonight, Digital Foundry tackles Mario Kart 8 Deluxe and praises its performance. When it comes to thorough looks at a game's performance, no one quite matches up to the keen eye of Eurogamer's Digital Foundry. They've recently uploaded their findings regarding the imminent Switch port of Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, and it looks pretty darn good. While the system is docked, the game runs at a higher resolution compared to the Wii U, 1080p versus 720p. Despite this leap, the game still maintains a solid locked 60 frames per second. Not only that, but some elements are even improved, such as a clearer texture presentation at tight angles and faster loading times. Unfortunately, anti-aliasing has not been implemented once again, meaning that while the game looks crisp, the pixel noise can be noticeable. If playing with one friend, the split-screen displays are 60 frames per second. However, if you are playing three or four players, the performance gets bumped down to about 30 frames per second. The undocked mode is where the re-release truly shines, though, with Digital Foundry making the sound decision to compare the game to the last handheld title in the series, Mario Kart 7. Even running at 720p, a match for the Wii U version, it's remarkable how much of a leap Deluxe is. If you can't wait to get your hands on this new version of Mario Kart, you are in luck. You're only about a week away. Mario Kart 8 Deluxe launches on the Nintendo Switch next week on April 28th. And finally tonight, Konami is ready to roll out yet another Super Bomberman R update. Super Bomberman R had a few issues at launch, such as a controller lag and a lacking number of stages. The game's already seen one patch to improve the lag, and it looks like another is due out later today to address other concerns. A tweet from the official Japanese Bomberman account announced it, stating the game will see some overall quality tweaks, difficulty adjustments, and a brand new stage. It's great to see them taking the time and effort to improve the game. Here's hoping this is going to be a regular occurrence for the game, keeping people coming back for weeks to come. And that's going to wrap up another installment of the Daily Wiretap for the evening of April 20th, 2017. As always, you can find a link in the description below to our full written article, and head over to NintendoWire.com for even more amazing Nintendo news. If you're looking for some really cool Amiibo news, we just uploaded a brand new Amiibo video unboxing Almond Celica from Fire Emblem Echoes. You can check it out by clicking the annotation on the screen right now. See you guys tomorrow. Bye.